You are watching Comedy Central.
In the not too distant future, next Sunday AD, there was a guy named Joel, not too different from you or me. Institute, just another face in a red jumpsuit. He did a good job cleaning up the place, but his boss didn't like him, so they shot him into space. We'll send him cheesy movies, the worst we can find. He'll have to sit and watch them all, then we'll monitor his mind. Now keep in mind, Joe can't control
you two, quit clowning around. Get out here. It's time to do our chores.
Never.
We are not allowed to fraternize with the human.
Oh, hi, everybody. My name is Joe. Welcome to the Satellite of Love. And my two robots, Tom and Crow, are currently hiding out from me in their super secret chocolate fudgy cardboard bat cave. You guys, this is your creator speaking, and I would like you to come out and start cleaning the load pan bay, if that's not too much to ask.
Ah, sorry. Mr. Crow and Mr. Servo are not in right now. Nope. I could get you a copy of their manifesto, which clearly states no be-jumpsuited humans are allowed on the premises.
I happen to have a manifesto here, Crow, that states you guys better get your little metal hinders out here or there's going to be some real trouble.
Ooker. So be it, Joel, but we'll have you know that we are Neo-Luddites who have abandoned the wicked ways of your filthy technology.
Yeah, we even hate ourselves. Yeah. Anarchy, anarchy.
You guys, listen, you better get out of here by commercial sign, or there's just going to be real trouble. That's all I can say.
Commercial sign in 5, 4, 3, 2,
we'll be right back.
Cheddar makes it taste better, right, Billy?
Hey, you missed the spot.
Nothing tastes better than hot cheddar on vegetables, huh, Billy?
More cheese, right,
Bill? The taste of cheddar makes darn near anything better. Isn't that right, Bill?
It's great.
Thought so. Cheddar makes it taste better.
This is Whose Line Is It Anyway?
30 minutes of extemporized wit, impromptu wisdom, and when things go wrong, totally unfeigned embarrassment.
Basically, anything can happen.
I'd like to complain about these contact lenses.
But I think, actually, I'm going to break wind.
Whose Line Is It Anyway? A semi-dignified, sort of Monty Python-ish improv comedy game show.
I got a message from my buttocks this morning.
Laugh or I'll kill myself.
Watch it, weeknights at 7:30, right here at Comedy Central.
This weekend, a super special sports monster at a super special time, super special moment.
Hey, where the hell's my Mr. Bubble?
Super special guest.
Why am I doing this?
Super special question.
What kind of a student athlete would Jesus be?
What kind of sports show do you expect on a comedy network?
Kids, they never forget. You had $10 on you?
Don't miss the first annual Sports Monster All-Star Hall of Fame All-American Super Special.
Yeah. You owe me $20.
Noon Saturday here at Comedy Central.
No. We can't come out, Joel, because this is a very controlled sensory deprivation experiment, and it'll ruin everything. I'm like John Travolta in The Boy in the Plastic Bubble. I pick up every little virus that comes along.
Yeah. There, I got him.
Ouch.
Magic on.
Those bots are wild. He should really discipline them more. I mean, they're cute and everything now, but once they get older, you won't be able to control them.
Sad, really.
Frank?
Yes, your Ginchiness?
Does it hurt much
Well, Gooper, as you discipline your little no-neck monsters, I'll be casually blowing you out of the water once again with this week's invention exchange. Everyone knows that plants love music, but no one has taken advantage of their vast knowledge of it. Frank?
Oh! Yes, that's why we slave bleak, horrible hours in our stifling lab, our knotty, gnarled hands doing black, unspeakable things, twisting God's work into our own hellish, slithering, mutatious thing. Until we came up with this, a plant that reviews music.
Why don't you start the tape, Frank?
I'll start the tape.
Beethoven's Waldstein Sonata, number 21, opus 53, is a prime example of a musical genius at the top of his form and maturity. The strong, sonorous chords in the first movement, the swiftly changing modulations, speed fluidly towards an exhilaratingly powerful climax of restated theme.
I thought it had no texture.
Bugger all.
Well, Joel, you know, that one didn't seem very scary for you guys. Anyway, my invention exchange this week is based on the premise that tattoos are far too permanent. I'll set the stage for you. Let's see. Portugal, Philippine Islands. You meet a really nice girl, and you have a couple of friendly shots, and you split the fire dog platter, but tomorrow morning, when you're on your way to Subic Bay, all you've got is a bellyache and a tattoo that says Mingo.
Yeah, but with this new non-permanent tattoo, you just peel up the sheet and start your life over again the right way.
You see, the problem is that people get tattoos when they're drunk, and they end up with irrational slogans. With this tattoo, you can erase those and write sensible things like grocery lists or your girlfriend's birthday.
What do you think, sirs?
Just what hurt?
Your experiment today, Joel, is probably the only film about a giant mutated guy that doesn't star Ted Cassidy or Richard Keel. It's the amazing Colossal Man. Put the hurt on him, Frank.
Live to serve you.
Hey, American International House of Pancakes.
Hey.
A sweet movie.
Scarecrow.
Scare me.
The time is 2:45 a.m.
Do you know where your children are?
15 minutes before time zero. At time zero, a new type of atomic explosion, a plutonium bomb, will be detonated at Desert Rock, Nevada.
So wake the kids.
These soldiers are to experience the plutonium explosion under simulated combat conditions.
Me? Maisie?
Creston?
Gomstopper?
Huh? Yeah. Oh, yeah, you wish.
Well, good one, Crow.
Thanks, I read it. Get your stinking credits out of my face!
And in our junior trombone section, Ken Langan in the first chair with Kathy Downs in the second.
And don't forget this year's Forensic League, Frank Jenks, Hank Peterson.
Russ Bender, he takes a lot of sick dates. Oh. Bender in the...
And Bruce Springsteen driving through Nebraska.
Hey. I am B-Rock! Ronald Sinclair, we've enjoyed his fine gas products.
Honey, don't count the white lines. You'll get sick.
Please remember, this is a great film. We hope you enjoy it, but we won't stop.
Hey, look up there. Neck braces by Joseph von Stroheim. Eric, actually.
Yeah.
Okay, I think we've given him enough credit.
Oh,
yeah. Ah, Bert I. Gordon produced and directed. He did everything. He's king of the world. All right, you win.
Okay, we're at Grandma's. Get your shoes on.
Attention! Attention! All personnel! The time is 0:30.
What time?
The time is 0:30.
I get a watch.
The plutonium explosion will take place at time 0. I repeat. The plutonium explosion will take place at time 0.
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
10, 9,
real tension builder here.
7,
6, 5.
Oh, I'm scared. I'm sorry I stole those batteries in the third grade.
1, 0. Hey, it's Amazing Colossal Dud.
Hit it. Wiggle the plug or something.
It's beeping.
Do not leave your positions. I will repeat. Do not leave your positions.
Assume the position.
The chain reaction did not complete its cycle as calculated.
Oh.
Keep your dark glasses on and stay where you are.
The snack bar will be closing in 10 minutes. Robert Peterson, pick up your free pizza.
I see. All right.
Well, she's got to work late again.
How does it look, Colonel?
It's dark.
I'm not sure.
How could a thing like this happen? They've set off lots of these bombs before.
Not a plutonium bomb, they haven't. This is the first one.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, can't we leave? Can't we get out of here?
No, Sergeant. You've got to wait until the chain reaction dampens or reaches a point of explosion.
So use your helmet.
Could go off in a second, a minute, 10 minutes, maybe not at all. Just have to wait it out.
For the rest of your life, Sergeant.
Can we smoke, sir?
I don't care if you burst into flame.
Keep hugging that trench wall closest to the bomb position. Won't be any warning when it goes.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Colonel.
Sounds like a plane.
I hope it's one of ours.
Oh, no, it's Amelia Earhart. She picked a bad time to come back.
I'll say.
Hello, Sarah. Get me my pilot.
There's a light civilian plane coming in at 190 degrees.
It's light and refreshing. No, it's zesty, and I think I see cheese on the wings.
Trampoline at the ready, sir.
Ground to pilot. Ground to pilot. This is control. Can you read me?
A bedtime story.
Still coming in.
Ground to pilot. You are flying over an atomic detonation area.
Oh.
You are flying over a restricted area.
Mm. It's Buddy Hackett and Mickey Rooney, too.
Change your heading 180 degrees.
But never change those little things I love about you.
Losing altitude fast.
Real fast.
He's going down.
Bring him in, Joel.
Come on.
That's good.
That's good.
Yeah, good sir.
Thanks. Good job. Set it anywhere.
Oh, cool. You can see the body and everything.
Was he killed?
Can't tell. He could be unconscious inside the plane.
No. I can see his pulse. He's alive, but his head's gone.
He'll go off any second.
That's the risk I'll have to take, Lieutenant. Now, you get out there. Control, that pilot could be alive. What about the bomb?
It's still activated, Colonel. Once the chain reaction has been triggered, there's nothing we can do to stop it.
But there's a man in that plane.
A man? Who cares?
No, boy. One weekend a month.
Stop, wait, come back.
Kind of runs like a girl.
Glenn, this is your father O'Malley. Come back, boy. It's not worth it.
Glenn, this is your first grade teacher. Don't do it.
Glenn, this is your mother. If you stop, I'll make your favorite dish.
Hey, FM stereo. It's really... Wait a minute. What the hell am I doing out here? Oh!
Well... Live and learn.
Yeah, you know what they say about Nevada. Don't like the weather, just wait a couple minutes.
And from that day on, they called him Patches.
Hey, I can see the president's face.
Coolidge. Next, on a very special Trapper John, M.D.
Mm-hmm. Adam and Eve on a raft and wreck them.
Extra sweet.
Never drink while you're under the sun lamp.
Mm-mm. I think we'll make him into a piñata.
Oh. Hey, that's pasta. He's the Amazing Colossal lasagna now.
Ooh. And then it says remove wrenched ankle. Ha, ha, ha.
We'll just stuff this back in anywhere. No one will know. Here's some more.
Nice use of watercress, Doctor. Nice presentation.
Another unit of blood, please.
Anyone else want anything?
Oh, I hope my roommate didn't drink it again.
a unit of blood, please.
Any kind. I don't care. Taps, okay. Thank you.
Nurse?
How did you know?
How is he?
He's not anything.
Where have they got Colonel Manning that was in an accident? They got him over in surgery there, sir.
Well, figures, I thought as much.
Hey. Brought him out yet? They don't hold much hope for him. It's quite a mess when they got to him.
Yeah,
a
real pile of goo. You know him?
Couldn't even find the plane or the pilot he was trying to save.
Oh, wait, there's more. I'm not finished yet. I was just going on to say that maybe...
You know, I was there covering the test for National News Service.
And I didn't run up next to the bomb.
Never seen anything like it. I've seen plenty.
Mm-hmm.
Please.
You a friend of his?
His fiancé.
Oh.
I'm sorry. What a fool.
But he really was
Please,
a mess.
Can I do something for you? Get you something?
Get you drunk, maybe?
Get you some beef stroganoff? Oh, I did it. I'm sorry.
How long have you known Colonel Manning?
What are you doing after he's dead?
Yeah.
Oh, how long can a 3-minute egg take?
Maybe if you talked about him, it'd help.
Yeah, it'll help talking about old pizza face.
Oh!
You said you were there when it happened. Was he conscious when they reached him, I mean? Was there much pain?
Well, no, I felt great. What?
Colonel since he got to the hospital.
I don't think he knew anything when that blast hit him. It's terrible. You know, they had the whole thing on film. There were 18 cameras embedded in concrete to shoot every phase of the explosion.
Look at this.
This weeds extremely well.
It took real expertise to create New Expert, a pet food that's scientifically formulated, the kind vets recommend, with no artificial flavors or colors. It took real expertise to make a diet so digestible that pets get more nourishment and produce less waste. But it took real genius to give it great taste. New Expert diets from Pedigree and Whiskas, expert nutrition from our vets, great taste for your pets.
Do you want to make more money? Sure, we all do. So call this free number to find out how easy it is to train at home for a better career. At ICS, more than 10 million men and women have prepared for new careers without setting foot inside a classroom. And now at home, in your spare time, you can get your diploma or your degree. Choose from any one of these courses. High school, TV, VCR repair, child daycare, computer programming, electrician, veterinary assistant, medical dental office, bookkeeping, legal assistant, interior decorating, gun repair, art, learning the personal computer, or get your degree. You can major in business management or accounting. Make this important call right now.
Call now for the free information Sally Struthers spoke about. Then decide if you want to train at home for a better job or career to make more money. Call 1-800-637-2000. There is no obligation. No salesman will visit you. Call 1-800-637-2000. Call right now.
What do you get when stand-ups sit down?
Most commonly used phrase in an Italian home is, no, really.
30 minutes of comedy masquerading as a talk show.
Oh, all right.
It's Comics Only, weeknights at 8:30, here at Comedy Central.
Third-degree burns on almost 100% of the body's surface, and the man still lives.
Looks kind of like Bluto when I do that. See that?
Well, the rules, he should be dead.
We were to be married tonight in Las Vegas.
Well, that went in the toilet, Toots.
We met in the funniest way.
Playing chicken with trains.
Our cars locked bumpers at a busy intersection in Chicago.
It burst into flames.
He was stationed nearby at Fort Sheridan. He got so mad. He still ribs me about my driving.
Ribs? That's what I'm hungry for.
No. Glenn is such a wonderful man.
Get her a Kleenex.
Doesn't deserve a break like this. Why did this have to happen to him?
Because he's rock stupid, honey.
Things like this just happen. There doesn't have to be a reason.
Oh, he's a Calvinist.
Mm. He must have protected his eyes with his arm. He apparently covered them when the blast hit. That's one bit of luck.
Stovetop stuffing.
Luck. Mm. This man's luck ran out long ago.
When he got me as a doctor, I have no idea what I'm doing.
He'll die of shock before morning, and if that doesn't do it, infection will.
And if that doesn't do it, I will.
Now be sure he gets penicillin and cortisone around the clock.
And keep stuffing him with cilantro.
Although I think it's useless.
There's always a chance.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Chance you give to a man who hasn't a square inch of skin left on his body. He's already lost enough body fluid to be fatal.
And what the heck are we doing here? Let's go have a sandwich. I got things to do, for crying out loud.
Jerry Paris.
Well, we've done all we can do. Now we'll just have to wait.
Yeah, poor bum's screams were muffled by a throat full of his own blood.
Ooh.
Oh, the lunch buffet.
Hi, honey. I'm your friend. Don't worry about me. I'll see you later. I gotta go to bed now.
Why is he ignoring me?
Hey, Hanger Roscoe here.
Well, what I usually do is roll him in the elevator and pick a floor.
Now, keep the room temperature at 80 degrees.
Not for him.
I'm on a constant check.
Wait a minute. Here's someone I can fall in love with.
Will he be all right, Doctor?
Yeah, right.
Carol? Your name was the only word he spoke.
Well, that and... Ah!
He's still alive.
He will be all right.
Well, keep the receipts for your shower gifts.
I wish I could give you some hope.
I prescribe me, Dr. Chad Feelgood. Ciao.
Next on Insensitive Hospital.
Oh, terrific. My fiance, the deli stacker.
What, are they giving his head a shower?
Yep. Keeping it fresh.
You know, if they would only take a little money and fix that roof, they wouldn't have to do that.
Well, now, would you like some shade? Oh, what's the point?
Quart low.
Morning sunshine.
And how is our little Johnsonville brat doing? Oh, you're thirsty, aren't you?
Well, something's much bigger than we expected. I'm sorry.
Hey, let me get my pants on.
Yes, Doctor, and plasma continuously.
Scissors, please.
You know, saran wrap has so many useful uses.
Make a tent. Hey, he's done, and he smells great. Oh, get the barbecue sauce.
What in the heck is the deal with this seaweed? Oh, I put it there. That's right. I was clowning.
Dark meat, please. Hey, get me a fork. I want to see how he's doing.
It's Phyllis Diller.
Hi. Developed new skin. How's it possible?
Maybe we got the wrong room, huh?
Yesterday, this was dead tissue.
Ooh.
And today... there isn't even a scar.
Neat.
What do you make of it, Paul?
When the skin is burned to the degree that it was on this man's body...
it's really icky.
It just doesn't grow back.
So what's the answer?
Vandals came in and put skin on him.
That's it. I don't know.
Hey, you guys really are doctors.
The skin.
What about it?
It's not burned. Well, he's going to be all right, isn't he?
Yeah, right, Dorothy. You can go back to Kansas now.
It was my idea to use the seaweed.
And since you played a major role in the development of the plutonium bomb, Mr. Kingman...
I'm going to show you cartoons.
We hope that you may be able to help us to understand or to learn how Colonel Glenn Manning survived the blast.
I brought you the film taken during the explosion, but I don't see what can be learned from it, as far as your patient is concerned. The accident was unfortunate, very unfortunate.
Mm-hmm.
What more can be said?
Can't you just let it lie?
There are two answers that we're looking for. Now, the first is, how Glenn Manning was able to survive the explosion.
Chance.
Mm-hmm.
It just happened that conditions were such that he was afforded a certain amount of protection.
Hmm. What explanation would you give for the new skin that's grown on his
grill
in a matter of hours?
What possible connection could there be to the bomb? A man survives an explosion, a plutonium explosion. Mm-hmm. And then, for some reason or other, his skin heals more rapidly than usual. What is the mystery, gentlemen?
Can I go? Just let me go!
When 60 or 70% of a person's body is burned, he doesn't have much chance for survival. Now, if he should live, the skin that was destroyed does not grow back. It remains dead scar tissue.
True or false?
When a man suffers over a 95% body burn and less than a day later looks normal, I'd say it was a mystery.
And you feel that plutonium may have some unknown quality that is responsible?
It's worth every effort to know.
Yep.
Now, I'll admit that you may be right. The plutonium possibly had nothing to do with it.
I'm losing,
aren't I? There may be
nothing
more to this than a freak of nature. But if there is something to it,
mm-hmm.
think of what it'll mean to medical science to have such a regenerative or healing power under its control.
Are you finished? Can I go?
Shall we do the film?
Yeah.
Turn it on. Come on. Lights! Can we have some lights? Come on! That's better.
Like many of the atom tests, we built a model town to see how it reacted to the explosion.
So there.
The protected cameras, such as this one, recorded the experiment. Watch this building when the heat of the explosion reaches it.
Well, there was a family of 12 in here. Oh, should have told them to leave.
Now the force of the blast.
This is your house, and you're in it, and I'm out here laughing.
Here's another building.
This is your mother's house.
First burned, and then disintegrated.
Right.
Whoa.
There's Manning.
Sourpuss.
First burned, then disintegrated.
This was seconds before the explosion.
Yeah, look at that jerk. Thinks he's a big man. Well, watch this big hero. Sure. All right, I proved my point. Turn it off. Turn it off. Come on, lights. Prono.
Oh, beautiful. Let's preview it out.
The fact that Glenn Manning lived after the blast, and the new skin completely replaced the burned dead tissue in a matter of hours, leaves only one conclusion.
He's God.
Something out there is beyond the limits of our knowledge.
Joel's getting ready to teach us one of those important lessons that's to be learned from today's experiment.
Hi, guys.
That jigs up.
What's the matter, you guys? You act like you don't want to hang out with me. I got a really great activity planned for you today.
Cool, great. You know, we kind of doubted that you did there.
I understand. It sometimes happens. But you're really going to love this. I found a way to derive a really important lesson from today's film and the experiment.
No.
So
right.
Check it out. Camba, let's roll this footage. You remember this sequence?
Uh-huh. Brought him out yet? They don't hold much hope for him. It's quite a mess when they got to him. Couldn't even find the plane or the pilot he was trying to save.
Huh, neat. So?
Well, what? You see, we could see clearly that this is no way to act around the spouse of a horribly disfigured nuclear accident victim.
Right.
Now, when we get back to Earth, I don't want you guys making the same mistake. No. So, what are some nice things we could say to this man's spouse to make her feel better?
Something caring and sensitive, like, I understand his face looks like a hot dish at a Lutheran potluck dinner.
No, that's not what I'm talking about.
Okay, I'd comfort her by saying, dear, you know, the scuttlebutt around the hospital is that now he's called the Amazing Jelly Man.
This is a hospital, you guys.
Oh, of course. Right.
Then I'd say something medical, like seeing him up close and in person gives me a better understanding of how the muscle groups work.
Come on. He'll sure come off the bone easy now.
Great.
That's it. Okay. I'm sorry I brought it up. I thought maybe you guys could have an aptitude for this kind of thing, learning human sensitivity.
What do you mean,
Joel? And I'm sorry.
Joel, we're very sensitive to your feelings, and you're in a bad spot.
I mean, think of it. You're stranded in space. You'll never see your family again, and when the orbit on the satellite decays, you'll be burnt to a crisp. But you never hear us talking about that when you're around.
That's right. We're sensitive to the reality of your situation here.
Yeah.
Now, for instance, we know your hair only looks like that because there's no barber on the ship, right?
Yeah, and even though your feet smell like cheese, we prefer to think they smell like good cheese.
That's right, and we know that if you had breath mints, you'd use them.
Yeah, it's not like you choose to leave a pheromone trail around when you walk.
So you see, Joel, buddy, we are sensitive.
Very sensitive. Yeah, yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You're very sensitive.
Well, so are you. You're equally sensitive to me.
You cried earlier. What was that about?
Finally, a talk show that's as bad as you want to be.
You know that life sucks after 18?
After Drive, Saturday at 4:30 here at Comedy Central.
AT&T is constantly searching for new ways to help our customers save money on long distance. And what we've recently discovered is remarkably simple. Those customers who spend over $11 a month on long distance could start saving right away by signing up for the AT&T Reach Out America plan. If you spend over $11 a month, you could save on long distance too. All it takes is one call to 1-800-341-5550. You'll learn how you could save 24 hours a day, 25% on calls made after 5 p.m., and enjoy discounts on daytime calls.
I guess you could say we're pretty good customers.
Who are you talking to?
If you spend over $11 a month in long distance, AT&T can help you save 24 hours a day, 25% on calls in the evening.
Honey, that sounded pretty good. Why don't we sign up?
We just did.
Great. Who do we call?
Call 1-800-341-5550 and sign up for the Reach Out America plan.
What's the first thing you think of when you hear the words dating service? Do you say to yourself, oh, they're for losers? Well, if you think like that, you're missing a lot.
Jeannie Collins talking about her membership in Together, the world's largest personalized introduction service.
I joined a dating service called Together, and it's been the best thing I've ever done for myself. I've met successful, intelligent, and very attractive men. What more could I ask for?
App Together, there are no videos, no anonymous computer matchups. App Together, your team with your own personal counselor who, after meeting with you, will know your likes and dislikes, the kind of person you're looking to meet, and then introduce you to that person. And now, Together is offering a free copy of Straight from the Heart. It's a brand new guide to the world of personal dating services, a book that will give you proven tips for successful dating, relationships, and romance. So find out more about Together and get your free no-obligation copy of Straight from the Heart. For your free copy, call 1-800-862-1000.
Hey, kid, know what day it is? It's the first day of school. The food's the same, but you got a new roommate.
School does not need to be this difficult.
Comedy Central wants to send George Carlin to your school for that tough first day. He'll say the things you can't.
I wouldn't eat that with somebody else's mouth.
He'll deal with the people you won't.
Well, you're an interesting guy, but I think you belong in the philosophy department.
And he's got $5,000 in cash to ease the pain. To enter, send a postcard to George on your campus, Radio City Station, P.O. Box 1033, New York, New York, 10101-1033. 'Cause, yeah, the first day of school is the worst, but with George Carlin along, it'll be a lot less sucky.
So, what did you learn on your first day of school?
Absolutely nothing, George.
Good. They're only telling you what they want you to know anyway.
This Comedy Central contest sponsored by Close Time.
Well, thanks a lot. You guys made me feel a lot better.
Oh, good. Oh, Domino's calling there. Get up. Pizza's ready.
It's me, the reporter. I just wanted to finish the story about my uncle's death at the meat plant. Okay, well, you see, my uncle works in Milwaukee, and...
I heard you were available.
Yes?
I'm Lieutenant Klein, attached to security at the Nevada testing ground. May I talk with you for a moment?
Well, if you're attached to security, how can you get through the door?
Colonel Manning, has something happened?
No, at least not that I know of.
Not yet.
Over as security officer attached to Colonel Manning.
I thought you were attached to security.
But you won't be able to visit the colonel at the hospital for a while.
But why?
For security reasons, ma'am. I wish I could tell you more, but well, I really don't know anymore.
I don't understand. What possible reason could there be to keep me from seeing him?
Well, I was with the colonel at the time of the accident, ma'am.
Good voice.
I wish I could help you. I'm only carrying out orders.
Oh.
But he is getting well.
I'm sorry. You'll have to wait until security is lifted.
No. How about that drink?
All right. Thank you, Lieutenant.
Good night, ma'am.
Good night.
Wow. A restraining order on little old me. Oh, I've got to face it. He fell for a nurse.
Oh.
Meanwhile,
let's see, original or extra crispy? Ah, this is the way this evening.
Wow, this is high security, isn't it?
Mm. Paging Dr. Fine. Dr. Howard. Dr. Fine.
Glenn's a pillow. Well, at least I can still snuggle him and turn him over to the cool side.
Well?
So?
Go on.
Excuse me. Could you tell me where they've taken Colonel Manning?
Oh, sorry, miss. I never heard of Colonel Manning.
But you must have heard something about him.
Sorry, miss, but I'm Nat King Cole.
Let me see. I was a student at a small Midwestern college.
Excuse me. My name is Carol Forrest. I'm Colonel Glenn Manning's fiancée.
Yes? Oh, bummer.
I was looking for Colonel Manning.
There's no visiting until 2 p.m. in the afternoon, Miss Forrest.
I know that. And I also know that Colonel Manning is no longer in his room on the second floor. Where have they taken him?
Let's see. Pound cake, chocolate mousse, a biscuit.
There's no Colonel Manning listed here.
Says so right on the
card.
There's
another house sooner, Barstow. Perhaps you've made a mistake.
I haven't made a mistake. I know Colonel Manning was here, and I insist on being told what you've done with
him. Ooh, I hope they start wrestling.
I'd like to speak to the hospital, please. He'll be back the day after tomorrow, so if you care to return.
Now, you can kiss my Aunt Fanny.
Where can I find Dr. Lindstrom?
Oh, would you stop?
Don't tell me you've never heard of him.
I've never heard of him. It says so right here.
Oh, you mean Dr. Lindstrom from Rochester.
That's right.
Well, he was only here for a few days. Called in on a special case.
Did he return to Rochester?
We wouldn't have that information.
Lies! Lies!
Yes, sir.
Come in, please.
Yes, sir. Excuse me.
Well, I hope you never find him. Tart.
She's wearing chainmail.
What's that? The pocket guide to plutonium consultants? Hmm. Yes, it is.
Susie thinks she doesn't need a seatbelt. Watch Susie go ballistic through the windshield.
Oh, this is Hazleton in the early days.
Hmm. Weighing 3 tons, this zippy car is perfect for the determined fiancé on the go.
Yeah, why don't you order up a gross of helmets? I'll take care of her. Hey, you toots.
I'm afraid you can't go any farther, miss. This is government property.
Is this the road to the hospital?
Yes, ma'am.
I've come to see Colonel Glenn Manning. I believe he's a patient here.
Oh, there are no patients here, ma'am. Not since the war ended.
Please, I've come a long way to see you.
Besides, I pay your salary.
Just a minute. I'll phone the sergeant.
Better.
Oh, did you order any wallet size, ma'am?
Got it!
Go! Chicken. Oh, they put a phone in his biffy?
The sergeant will see you. Now, you stay on this road about a quarter of a mile and you can't miss it. You'll find the sergeant just inside the main entrance.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very little.
Hey, wait, the sign says turn back. This means you.
Xanadu, palatial home of Charles Foster Kane. Cost, no one can say.
Rosebud. Rosebud. This is nice. The floor was just waxed.
Be careful.
Hey, I think that window would make an excellent puppet area.
Yeah.
Puppet stage.
It would. She kind of looks like Fran Allison, actually.
Yeah.
Dr. Lindstrom, report to laboratory.
That's me.
Can I help you, miss?
I'm looking for an army officer.
Hey, who is it?
Was transferred here.
Oh, what's his name, ma'am?
Colonel Glenn Manning.
Hmm. Colonel Manning.
Oh, you mean old Peel and Eat Manning.
Colonel Manning here, ma'am.
Oh, I see. Thank you, Sergeant. I was told that he might be here. Obviously, the party was mistaken.
Sorry, I couldn't help you, miss. The guard will let you out the gate.
Thank you.
Some party. What, the government's involved in a cover-up? How could that be?
Well, I'm leaving then. I'm off. There's the door slamming. No, the door's closing now. I'm outside now. I'm in my car. I'm getting in my car. I'm leaving.
It worked.
Oh, this is probably before they knew the effect of lighting on worker happiness.
I'm guessing. Mm-hmm. Hospital Noir. Mm-hmm. Is she loud enough?
Oh, just walking by, not seeing anything.
That was close. Too close.
Hate it to disturb you, Paul, but I thought you ought to see him.
Has he had his intravenous feeding?
Yes. Yeah, I had some trouble getting the hamburger down the tube, though.
Rapid. I can't understand.
See you, lady.
Give me a stethoscope, Eric.
A really big one.
He's breathing much more rapidly now. Changes every hour. Never be.
Boy, it's dark. Need a light? Ever get sick of doing these expositions? Talking when the camera's not on you? I do.
Now keep the room temperature at 80 degrees. I want to constantly check when he's 12 hour by hour.
Right.
And I keep dabbing him with butter and rubbing with garlic clove every half hour.
See you, lady. You can head on in there if you want.
Honey, are you decent?
She's got nothing but Teddy on under that coat, you know.
Wish.
Little surprise.
Oh, my fiance, the sumo wrestler!
Oh. Rosebud!
That'll happen.
Now, Comedy Central offers you the same great catchphrases used by America's top professional comedians.
Okay! You look marvelous.
Didn't we just want to pop? You are.
Well, isn't that special?
Party on, girl.
Party on, Liz.
Where's Liz? Where's Liz?
Find your signature slogan at the original Catchphrase Clearinghouse. Saturday night live. Saturday at 9, only at Comedy Central. The Comster, the Central Meister, El Comedio.
Now, Glade Country Pottery air fresheners have fresh, new designs.
Put out the pottery. Put it here, put it there.
Handmade pottery, now in decorative designs.
Put it everywhere. Put out the pottery. Put the fresh country air anywhere.
The porous clay releases the light, fresh scent for 30 days.
Just put out the pottery. Put the fresh country air everywhere.
Put out the pottery in new decorative designs. About to hear some of the most beautiful soft rock hits ever recorded.
You know I love you, but I just can't take
Heartland Music presents Always. 40 unforgettable hits.
I don't know how much, but I know I love you. Oh, girl.
Classic love songs.
How I depend on you.
But it's not sold in any store.
Ever I saw your face.
Please stay tuned to order.
My eyes have told you.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-922-3131. To save all COD charges and pay only $19.98 for records or cassettes or $24.98 for compact discs, plus $4 shipping, use your credit card or send check or money order to Always FDR Station, P.O. Box 5020, Department B, New York, New York. Remember, save COD charges by sending check or money order or use your credit card.
There were many reasons why we didn't let you in on Colonel Manning's condition, Miss Forrest.
In the Twilight Zone.
Primary being that Washington gave the strictest orders that he be isolated.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for obvious reasons, they ordered a security restriction over the whole affair.
I want to help. Is there something I can do?
We're doing everything that can be done, Miss Forrest.
What happened? What made him grow?
Wonderful. Glenn Manning is growing from 8 to 10 works. Feet a day. The moment, he's 18 feet tall. Tomorrow, he'll be 26 feet. The next day, 35, maybe 40.
Okay, okay. Look, we get the point already.
Miss Forrest, we're trying. Believe me, we're trying. Let me explain it to you. Now, you probably already know the body is like a factory.
But there's a lot of underpaid workers in it?
Producing new cells to replace the older cells, damaged cells or destroyed cells. Uh-huh. Now, this happens in all the different parts of the body.
Yeah.
Bone cells grow new bone cells. Skin cells grow new skin cells, and so on, throughout the body. Now, here, let me show you. This is an example of bone growth.
It's like an x-ray.
Became the heel bone shown in this x-ray by means of bone cell growth.
Hmm.
Now notice that the new cells join the broken bone together so that you no longer see any break. Now, a cut, see in your hand, heals in the same way.
With he's losing me, but I don't dare say anything.
It is this delicately balanced process of new
nice
cells
replacing
dying cells or damaged cells that is causing the growth problem with Glenn.
But how can this make his whole body grow?
Process is out of balance. For some unknown reason, new cells are growing at an accelerated or speeded up rate, while at the same time, the old cells are refusing to die. This is what makes Glenn grow.
Grow,
Glenn, grow.
Glenn Glow?
Then if you can stop this from happening...
We can stop his growth.
It's just like Clifford the Big Red Dog.
And if you can't...
Then Glenn Manning will continue to grow until he dies.
Oh, I'll never keep him in tennis shoes.
Or jockstraps.
Ooh.
Oh, my goodness, I'm growing so fast, I'm giving myself a wedgie.
Oh. Well, look on the bright side, Glenn. At least you got a room with a phone.
S enters Korean Wa.
I hear about that.
Man, grills just scare the heck out of me. I don't know why.
There was no reason for you to volunteer. You should have waited until you were called.
Honey, I'm in the reserve. They could have called me eventually anyway.
But it just isn't fair. You were just getting started. You've got your future to think about.
I am thinking about it. Thinking about yours, too. Darling, we're going to get married just as soon as the thing's over.
They can't last long.
Honey, will you please stop worrying?
When you're safe at home, then I'll stop worrying.
Say, a hot dog makes you lose control.
And then there were other things, too, things that had to do with Korea. Yeah.
Hey, what, are we watching the Arts and Entertainment Network?
The All-Hitler Channel, you mean? I'm Mike Wallace, and this is Biography.
Stock footage is hell.
Oh, baby! Oh, that's mean.
This war sucks, Sarge.
I guess they've stopped.
Yeah.
He's playing the Trini Lopez part.
You all right, Carter? Yeah, sure.
Hey, you saved the coupons, dog face?
Sure. How do you think I got this neat war?
That last one was close.
How are the rest?
Oh, not so good.
You die, Joe!
No! No!
Message for you, sir.
Hurts, don't it? Tell your friend.
Hershey's.
Rotten. Smile on your face all the time. They want to take your place, the backstabbers.
Backstabbers?
Thank you.
Well, I see he made his quietus with bare vodka, whatever that means.
And the other things, too. Horrible things. Things with necks and bands.
John Philip Sousa's life is flashing before his eyes.
Weird.
They're coming home. One of them wars.
Honey, this is the longest picnic I've ever been on.
7, 6.
Oh, no.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Seen it. Taped it.
Oh, no. Again? I gotta do this? No!
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
The horror. The horror. Wait a minute. Huh? Feel like chopping a cow in half. Oh, French provincial.
Oh, my God. I'm being held in Barbie's Malibu dream house.
Wait until he sees the toilet.
Ooh, horrible.
You know, you have an all-night bender and your college buddies play tricks on you.
Hi, this is Mickey Rooney. Billy Bobby's on the line, too.
Hello, operator.
Short distance. Maybe you know.
Oh, my goodness, I'm a huge Daddy Warbucks.
Not taking it well, is he?
How soon will the tent arrive?
It's being flown in from Circus Winter Quarters in Florida.
And the caterers?
Well, he's already outgrown his room, you know. Well, as soon as you get the tent up, we'll break out the wall and move him.
Right.
Dr. Lindstrom?
Time to get your dress refitted.
The reason I sent for you was that Manning regained consciousness during the night. Now, at the moment, he's suffering from the shock of learning about his condition. Mm. He won't talk to anyone.
Oh, please, may I see him? I know he'll talk to me.
See him? You can't
see
miss
him,
him.
By all means. You know, psychologically, you may do him a lot of good.
But don't climb on him.
To move quietly and unemotionally. You know, at his size, he's capable of pulling these walls apart.
Mm.
His height was over 22 feet this morning.
I understand.
Yeah, remember, to him, you look like a breadstick.
Yeah, oh, big, oh, huge, big, big, oh, big.
Glenn?
You look like Mr. Clean, Glenn. The Procter & Gamble people are on the phone.
Glenn?
Hey, I'm huge. I'm not deaf.
Won't you talk to me?
He's tired. I'm huge. Don't smoke. I'm huge now.
They'll be able to help you. I know they will.
Honey, I'm still looking forward to our wedding night.
The doctors are working night and day to find a cure for you, and they're very hopeful.
Call Genghis. Tell him to let out my tux.
Why, they're flying in Dr. Mayer from Sweden.
Hmm? Sweden?
He's one of the greatest specialists of cellular research and medicine. What else can I say to help you, Glenn?
What sin could a man commit in a single lifetime to bring this upon himself?
Beats me.
Oh, my leg! I broke it! Oh, my shoulder! Ooh!
Hey, look at the bright side. You can put the star on the top of the tree.
Morning, and Glenn orders breakfast. Huge brown and served sausages are shipped in. Hundreds of skillet scrambles are prepared with pancakes on the side and twin berry syrup by the truckloads.
Meat delivery.
Meat delivery.
Did someone say meat?
Hey, Bud.
Don't call me Bud.
What's with this meat order they called in? I thought the army hauled in its own stuff.
Come on, move on.
Oh,
food delivery to the stockroom behind the kitchen. You'll find it at the far side of the main building.
25 sides of beef. Who's going to eat it all? They haven't had any patients out here since the war ended. You fellas must eat pretty well.
We'll invite you to dinner so you can help us. Now move this truck out of here.
No.
And take off that plate
pin. What's the tent for?
It's a science fair, dope.
That's mighty funny.
We're going to have a circus every Saturday.
Oh, now, come on.
You're the geek.
You know, the big secret. I won't breathe it to you, so.
All right. If I tell you, will you move this truck?
Right.
Right.
It's for him.
For who?
The giant.
What giant?
The 30-foot one we got living here.
Here you have.
Wah, 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 wah. Truth is stranger than fiction.
Yeah, I get your 30-foot man right here, buddy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
us 24 hours, we'll give you 77 years of the funniest people ever. Watch the history of comedy, a 24-hour marathon, all day, Sunday, August 18th, only at Comedy Central.
Cold War's long gone. Berlin Wall's history. Kind of sad, really.
Why is that?
Well, I always wanted to be a top-secret agent. Codename Mozart. You know, make it through Checkpoint Charlie by the skin of my teeth.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's all over now.
I know. But at least I can read about the good old days in my Encyclopedia Britannica. Check out this section on intelligence and counterintelligence.
That's not all you can read about in the new Encyclopedia Britannica.
Somehow I knew sooner or later you'd turn this into a commercial.
Well, actually...
It's okay. I know. How else can someone find out how to get a set? Forget secret agent. Look at these great animals. Maybe I'll be a veterinarian. Open wide. You gonna pop on that 800 number?
I thought we might, yes.
Right on cue.
To find out how you can own the new Encyclopedia Britannica, just call this number and we'll send you this free booklet.
Don't forget the gift.
And just for previewing Britannica in your home, we'll give you this three-volume desk reference set.
I already have it.
I was talking to the people at home.
Oh, right. Sorry.
Encyclopedia Britannica.
We all know how much fun playing the guitar can be, but until now, learning meant months of tedious lessons costing hundreds of dollars and getting limited results. Well, no more. Now you can learn to play any guitar in only 30 days. In fact, you'll actually be playing from the very first day, even if you've never held a guitar before. How's it possible? With the revolutionary Guitar Today video program. Rock, country, folk, pop, or jazz, you'll be playing guitar from the very first day.
When I first heard about the Guitar Today video, I was skeptical. But I tried it, and now I'm playing electric guitar in my own band.
I ordered the tape for my son, and he played his first song in only one day. Then my daughter used the program, and she did just as well. Now my husband is showing off with how well he played.
Use your credit card and order your two-hour videotape and instructional workbook for only $29.95 plus $3.95 shipping. Call now, 1-800-726-6000. That's 1-800-726-6000. Or send your check to the address shown. Sorry, no CODs.
What kind of sin could a man commit in a single lifetime to bring this upon himself?
No! Joel? Won't you talk to us?
Oh, go away. I'm huge.
We'd like to ask you a few questions.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel?
Yeah.
What do you mean, how do I feel? I feel huge. I'm a 50-foot man. No.
Do you think you're having delusions of grandeur?
Oh, he's a colossal man. Of course he's having delusions. Oh, ask him another question.
Who's your favorite monkey?
What?
Oh, here, let me.
Sorry.
How many fish can you name?
Yeah, that's a good one.
How many fish can I name? What kind of questions are these? I'm a 50-foot tall man. You don't care about me. Go away.
Oh, that's not true, Joel. We're trying to do everything in our power to help you.
Mm.
No, this isn't working. I don't think anything can save him.
Nah, he's just being difficult because he's a freak.
Yeah, let's try plan B, okay?
Oh, yeah, plan B, okay.
Joel, are you still there?
Of course I'm still here. I'm immense. I'm huge.
We have someone here who can help you.
Go ahead.
Honey, I'm really still love you, and I'm not going to leave you in this position. Condition. Oh, someone's at the door.
Hello. Hi there, honey. How would you like to go out with a normal man tonight?
All right, come on. That's it. This is getting too weird, you guys. Forget
hey,
it.
Servo, how'd you get your arm to work?
Oh, that's it. Every time I try to teach you guys a little something about human nature, you got to twist it around into one of your little jokes. Well, listen, you guys can just turn around and sashay those little robot metal butts of yours into the theater where you can learn a real something about isolation and loneliness.
We're sorry, freak.
Oh, we got movie time!
Oh, that really hurt, Joel.
Sorry.
That wall coming down.
Now let's bring away from the theme side of the news. Many people are asking what happened to Colonel Glenn Manning, the Army officer who was exposed to the rays of the plutonium bomb at Desert Rock, Nevada, a few days ago.
Hmm.
Eyewitnesses of the incident state that to all accounts he should have died.
How?
In the blast.
Oh.
Is he alive or dead?
Or Memorex.
What's all the mystery for, Washington? Here in Las Vegas.
Well, time to die. Avon calling. Sorry.
I'll just call you Little Mary Kay.
Well, Fluffy, time to shave your butt and put cosmetics all over it.
Oh. Man, those things really made.
What are they?
I'm impressed.
What's up, Doc?
Nothing yet. Hey, how's the glass sidebar coming there?
Let's try it.
What the hell? I've got a wild hair. Daddy's got to shoot up first.
Why don't you put on Sid and Nancy for me?
Oh, no, not there! Please, ow! Oh,
have a nice trip, Fluffy.
Oh, the
now, let's set him on the TV and see if we get better reception.
Oh, I can't see streaking. Oh. Not cell block B! It's the toughest cell! Hey, pass it down. Oh. Night of the Leapers! Tonight!
Would you mind if I tried something on my own? What is it?
Oh, some crystal meth and a leather clown suit.
I'd like to attempt a practical application of the cellular theory we discussed yesterday. Fine.
I've made it into a song, and I'd like to sing it at your wedding.
By the way, where's Manning?
I thought you knew.
Oh, Carol. You know, he shouldn't be permitted to walk around. He should be confined.
Fined?
What, he weighed this morning? 2,987 pounds.
Soaking wet.
Well, looks like the job is ready.
Okay, who's
Let's
next?
Let's see. 5 hours. Which should make him over 30 feet tall.
And a real fashion plate at that.
You know, it's funny, Carol.
Who do you think drove?
I was sitting here like this on the hillside, away from people and things.
Big and all. Hey, pull funny. My finger.
Reminds me of that picnic that we took once.
1952 through
1955. You know, time has lost all perspective.
So has this movie.
It's been a lifetime since that explosion. Everything that happened before seems another world.
What?
Another
that was a wonderful time.
Huh?
What'd you say, Carol? Before I became a monster?
No, I was going to say freak.
You see, I don't mind a bit.
You shouldn't.
I shouldn't what? Talk about it? Think about it? Do you realize that every breath I take, every movement,
I'll be watching you.
Everything reminds me of what happened? Even when I try to sleep at night, close my eyes so I won't see people in the world getting smaller every minute.
What a drag.
The beating of my heart keeps getting louder and louder, reminding me
that I should cut down on my salt intake.
I should never have lived through that blast.
You're alive, Glenn, and as long as you are, there's always hope.
You know what they wrote about me in the college yearbook?
Dickweed.
A man most likely to reach the top.
Oh.
Hey, don't laugh, Glenn. We're on a fault line.
I know it is. The doctors are working night and day to find a cure. They feel that if they can stop your growth, they may be able to bring you back to normal.
But to find normal.
You don't really believe that.
I don't.
They'll never find a cure for me.
Well, I was just trying to make conversation. Gee.
Are you all right? Shall I go for Dr. Lindstrom?
Nope.
I'm all right.
Cutoffs are just a little tight. The eyes are folding out.
I'm all right. I just don't want to grow anymore.
I'm a Toys R Us kid.
I don't want to grow anymore.
I'm a Toys R Us kid.
He was sitting on a bush.
Glenn.
Ooh.
Glenn. I don't believe he doesn't want to ride home.
Have you seen Glenn?
It's not going so well, is it? Doesn't he have any relatives?
Somebody could move
no.
in with.
He's all alone except for me.
Carol, do you mind if I spoke bluntly?
Why stop now?
It's no good for you to be here.
But who has more rights?
Well, in this case, I feel the right can be wrong.
And wrong is right, and vice versa.
At first, I thought it might do him good to have you near. And, of course, the government insisted that you stay.
Mm-hmm.
However, I'm going to recommend the security be lifted in your case.
How can you ask me to turn my back on the only person who's ever meant anything to me?
Easy.
Why, I've got to be here to try to help him get well.
Suppose that he doesn't get well.
Well, I hadn't thought of that. I guess I'd abandon him.
Drive back to the laboratory. There's something I want to show you.
Pony, Glenn tried that line once.
Bow. Bow, 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 bow. Oh, I hate camping. Yuck, da, 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 da. Why do they keep putting these little chairs in here? They just do it to bug me.
Gallons of hospital jello.
I'm turned down service, sir. Excuse me.
I don't know what it is, but these hospital portions are always too damn small.
Why, do you expect a tip?
The x-axis intersects the y at the following three points, giving us to conclude that the square root of the sum of the parts is equal to y minus x divided by 4.
What he says is not necessarily true.
George on your campus. Details coming soon here at Comedy Central.
A new American cheese snack idea. Grill it up and slice it up so little fingers can pick it up. Cut it up, fun it up, guaranteed they'll eat it up. American cheese. Kids are up for it anytime.
It's the greatest name in sewing machines. Introducing the Singer Handy Stitch, the most convenient Singer ever. Just thread it in seconds and away you go. The durable chain stitch assures a clean, secure job every time. There's no bobbin to wind, fuss with, or lose. Handy Stitch has genuine Singer toughness. Yet it's so simple and safe a child can use it. Make on-the-spot repairs, beautiful decorations, straight stitches, curved stitches. Handy Stitch has hundreds of uses and goes anywhere you go. It comes complete with 5 mini spools of thread, an extension spindle for your own standard spools, plus convenient battery pack and accessories. It's a genuine Singer for only $29.95. Here's how to order.
Call toll-free 1-800-767-9400. That's 1-800-767-9400. Or send $29.95 plus $5.95 shipping and handling to Singer Handy Stitch, 2 Morgan Avenue, Norwalk, Connecticut.
I came out of the Navy, and I knew I needed some more education. It had to be something that companies respected. It had to be something that the companies would look at and say, hey, we want you.
At DeVry, you learn the skills that today's companies need, and you earn a degree they respect.
Best thing about DeVry is the quality of education and the quality of respect that other companies give DeVry.
Get the degree companies respect. Call 1-800-247-7800. DeVry, we're serious about success.
Sunday nights, let Comedy Central seduce you with 7 hours of late-night classics.
Say that slow and strap me in.
Classics, just the way you like them, all night long.
Yes, beast.
Just when you think you're not getting enough, Comedy Central gives you what you want. Someone to spend Sunday nights with.
How lovely that was.
Thank you.
Why sleep with strangers when you can go to bed with those you know and love? Late-night classics, Sundays at Comedy Central.
No, you're not going to wipe your mouth on me again, are you? Please.
Hey, how'd the Giants do?
What's new in the paper, Sergeant?
About you, sir.
Let's have it.
Picked it up at Tom Thumb. Just kidding.
Oops. Running safe.
Oh, Lockhorn. Burned the dinner again. He came home late.
Man lives through plutonium blast. That's a great joke, isn't it, Bert?
I must have missed the setup, sir.
They call this living.
Not the phlegm again, sir. Not the phlegm. No, project the law. Look out. Oh, that's your chamber pot, sir.
Ooh. Ooh. No more. It's so funny.
Ah, the healing power of laughter. He must have read Anatomy of an Illness by Norman Cousins. Let's see. Laughter.
All right, Sergeant. Why don't you ask me what it feels like to be a freak?
Well, what's it feel like to be a freak?
This is how it feels to be so big you can stick your fist through a second. Who else but a clown would have an expandable sarong like this?
Oh, Shelley Winters.
It's adjustable. I can grow to be 100 feet tall, and I don't need a change of wardrobe. Army ingenuity.
Sir, may I leave?
Why? You want to go back to your quarters and tell your friends about the monster? About the circus freak?
As a matter of fact, yes.
I'm a circus freak. Have a tent. We'll travel. Why don't you make me up a sign saying, see the amazing colossal man.
Or see the giant roll-on deodorant.
That was it, wasn't it, Sergeant? You do think I'm a freak, don't you?
Yeah, you're a super freak, sir. The kind you don't take home to Mother.
With me, it's different. I think you're the freak. I think you're the one that's different.
Checking off.
I'm not growing. You're shrinking.
Not only am I bigger, I'm funnier. My jokes are better. Oh, hey, Glenn, time to let out the sarong.
Oh, the pain, the pain.
Feel that if you understand the circumstances more thoroughly, you will realize why it will be better for you to leave.
Oh, nice guy.
Now, this is a step-by-step illustration of Glenn's circulatory system.
All four veins.
To his growth. Mm-hmm. Now, this illustration represents Glenn shortly after the accident.
He was only 2 feet tall.
This one is of Glenn as of a few hours ago.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you look closely at each one, you will notice that all the parts are enlarging at the same ratio, except for the heart.
Now, we've never met before, have we?
When it was of normal size, the heart measured approximately the size of the distance from his nose to his chin. However, at the size he is now, the heart measures the same as the distance from his lips to his chin.
I don't get it.
In other words, the heart has increased one half as much as the other parts of the body. Now, remember when I explained the other day why Glenn was growing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you put me
I
in a coma.
All the parts of the body consisted of millions of tiny cells that were rapidly and uncontrollably multiplying.
Like rabbits.
Well, today we've learned that this theory does not apply to Glenn's heart.
Hmm.
It is growing, but at a much slower rate.
Oh.
Now, the reason for this is rather technical, Carol, but to give you a simplified layman's explanation.
He's really big.
It might be explained that since the heart is made up of a single cell, for all practical purposes, instead of millions of cells like the rest of the organs of the body, it's reacting in an entirely different manner to this unknown stimulus or force that's behind this whole thing.
You're not a real doctor, are you?
So, what's with all the dead rabbits, doctor?
No wonder he's always complaining about those sharp pains in his chest.
Single
cell. What does it mean?
He's toast.
Simply this, Carol. Then unless we can find a way to stop Glenn's growth very soon, his heart won't be able to carry the load any longer. And he'll die.
Of a broken heart.
How soon?
Matter of days.
So, dinner?
How will it happen?
Details.
His mind will go first. And then his heart will literally explode.
So, don't wear a white dress that day.
Why is this horrible thing happening?
Because Glenn's a sinner, dear.
I've searched everywhere for the answer, and I can't find it.
The answer's in your shoes. I have no idea why.
All night, I lie awake thinking, why does it have to happen?
Which question do you want me to answer first?
Well, you'll have to tell me.
No, dear. I'm only a vet.
I wish I knew.
Now, how's that feel, Glenn? Huh?
No!
I've got to make
Don't
my report.
Ever today. Do that!
Anything yet?
Nothing conclusive.
Right.
Where's he going?
Hmm?
Hello, General.
General? Private?
I'm a quick change artist. What do you think?
We don't have time to become discouraged, Eric. We've got to find an answer quickly.
Tell Carol?
Yeah. She still won't leave. Well, I can't say that I blame her, but she's got to go. We can't take any more
Oh,
chance.
Geez, you're really obsessed, aren't you?
Yep.
Any change in the new animals?
None.
They're dead.
Absolutely no change of any kind. I checked their galvanic reflexes on the hour every hour.
Mm-hmm.
Results are the sum total of absolutely nothing. Paul, I don't think we've got a chance.
Whoa, a little passionate there,
it's
Doctor.
It's just great. On paper. It just doesn't stand up under practical application.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. You know, this is a great place.
Have you had a chance to clean your end of the office yet?
No, Eric.
Who took a bite out of the horse?
Might be better if we concentrate the experiments with the guinea pigs and the rabbits in the lab. Since time is so important, we have the advantage of their short life cycle.
Well, the small animals can't stand up to the high-frequency stimulation.
Stop ad-libbing.
Let's continue the injections with the small animals and confine the high-frequency experiments to these.
And, of course, continue with the beatings.
Seems logical.
Everything seems logical.
This late at night.
Look at our giant.
I don't mean this to sound like a come-on line, but does anyone here want to have sex?
I like this one, because he has nice lips.
Just sit down!
I take out my Zippo lighter. And I light my shirt on fire. Burns up.
That's right, I'm the guy. The guy with a good attitude towards menstruation.
It's Tommy Lasorda with a way to help you lose weight that's gonna shake things up. Ultra Slim Fast Fruit Juice Mix.
Juice it up, lose weight.
Mix it with your favorite fruit juice.
Juice it up, lose weight, feel great.
It's a delicious, nutritious part of the Ultra Slim Fast plan.
Juice it up, lose weight, feel great.
Ultra Slim Fast Fruit Juice Mix.
Give us a week, we'll take off the weight.
Ouch. Ouch! Double ouch! There must be a better way to get rid of unwanted hair. Now there is! Introducing Azara, a new method that removes hair quickly, easily, painlessly, and keeps it off up to 10 full weeks. Azara is more effective than any other method. It's a lot quicker than tweezers and epilators, lasts much longer than shaving, contains no harsh chemicals like creams, is much cleaner than waxes, and costs only pennies to use. Use it wherever you have unsightly or unwanted hair. You'll feel comfortable and attractive all over. Azara is only $19.95, but order now and get a second tube free. If you're not delighted, return it for a complete refund. Have your credit card ready and call now.
To order, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-733-9300 or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $4 shipping and handling to Azara 4100 American Way, Roanoke, Virginia, or call 1-800-733-9300.
Look fast, because the hands on this watch are about to disappear. Now, look again, and they're back. Why do these hands disappear? Because they're not really hands at all. They're actually electronic pulses of light. Introducing the amazing laser beam wristwatch. Destined to become a legend in its own time, we believe it will soon be one of the most sought-after watches in history. However, as part of a special publicity campaign, we will send you one of these amazing new laser beam luxury watches. Not for the hundreds of dollars you might expect, but for only $10. But to get your amazing laser beam wristwatch for only $10, you must act now. If you call within the next 30 minutes, you can order a second laser beam watch for only $5, just half price.
To order, call 1-800-733-3700. That's 1-800-733-3700.
Chaplin, Fields, Lloyd, Keaton, Benchley, Langdon, Laurel and Hardy. They all made movies, they're all dead, and they're all here at Comedy Central. Classic movies by classic comics, hosted by Robert Klein. Dead Comic Society, Sunday morning at 10 Eastern, here at Comedy Central.
Wedding, contour sheet. Oh, my leg's caught.
Ooh.
Glenn, are you up, honey?
Well, 130 Rob Roys, and he's in the other room talking to Earl.
Mm-hmm. Glenn?
Hello, Carol.
Oh, I didn't see you there.
Frighten me, Glenn.
What did you expect? Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs?
No, Dumbo.
I heard you cry out in pain. I was worried about you. Tomorrow may be an important day, Glenn.
Sexy pose.
He's been experimenting with some animals. A theory of some kind he's been working on. And he said he'll know the results by morning.
How tall do you suppose I'll grow?
Okay, I'll bite. How tall?
Before death releases me from this curse.
Well, the company pool says 155 feet.
Maybe 1,000?
Million?
Could be a mile.
Possible.
Can you imagine that, Carol?
Please, Glenn, don't torture yourself.
But it's fun.
I wouldn't actually have to worry too much about breathing until I got about 3 miles up. The oxygen starts to thin up there.
3 miles.
Glenn.
You're bumming me out.
Pause, Carol. They're not going to find the answer tomorrow or any tomorrow.
Hey.
You just picked the wrong number. Go on, pick up your chips. Go on home.
Take that dip with you, too.
I think I could leave you alone at a time like this?
You never did know when to quit, did you?
Nope.
Well, can you take a hint? I want you to get out and leave me alone. I don't want you around, do you hear?
Say whatever you wish to me, Glenda. Please, please hold on until they try everything possible. There must be a cure for it. There must be.
Suppose they stop it. So what? I stop growing. What then? Can't you imagine what a wonderful life we'd have together?
A big yard and a big house and a...
up here and you down.
You down downtown? Down with it?
What
down
in
the
nasty? Please, is there anything I can do?
Yes! Get out! Leave me alone!
So I'll just be leaving.
A dresser for?
Little pants.
No man is a 3 mile island, Glenn. You know, that was wonderful, Carol.
So, how's the Tower Heroine Danny coming there?
Eric, we can't find him anywhere on the grounds.
But you've got to find him.
Well, Colonel Halleck, security officer for the area, is out canvassing the desert with his men.
My fault. I had an argument with him last night.
We heard.
Well, it won't go far. Paul, I've got the answer.
It's Cocoa Puffs, Bob. I have no idea why, but it fits the equation. Check it out. There's the skim milk, and then there's the Cocoa Puff. And you see?
Brilliant.
The answer is in the bone marrow. The bone marrow. We were so close we couldn't see it.
Yeah. We'll need your bone marrow, Carol.
Dr. Lang's work on radiation exposure. Sulfahydro. Inject sulfahydro compounds into the bone marrow.
Exactly. The thing that fooled us was we were looking for some unknown quantity in the plutonium radiation, while all the time it was acting to a degree the same as a hydrogen exposure. The secret was in the degree of the exposure.
Well, then injections of the sulfahydro compound should correct the body's regenerative balance.
Or not.
Well, I can see where this would stop his growth, but...
You do think you can save him?
It may stop his growth, but it won't diminish his size.
The stimulation of the hormone secretions in the pituitary or growth-controlling glands will take care of that.
Abba-dabba, abba-dabba.
You know, it doesn't sound practical, Eric. I don't think it'll work.
Here, take a look.
Let's do it on the 3D BB.
See, I made it myself, and I'm proud.
That's amazing.
Oh, brother.
That's a Sony.
He's invented the TV.
I use high-frequency stimulation of the pituitary gland.
causing the hormone secretion to reverse the growth process.
Well, these things could revolutionize Thanksgiving.
First, injections of the sulfahydryl compounds into the bone marrow, that will stop the growing. And then stimulate the pituitary gland to reduce its size.
I can do that.
Like this?
No, give me that.
You think you'll be able to inject him with a hypodermic needle this size?
I've had an oversized needle constructed. As a matter of fact,
doctor...
Hey, can I take those home to my kids?
I couldn't find Manning anyplace. My men covered an area of 10 square miles.
Well, we can't lose him. Now we just can't.
Just when we have the problem licked.
Colonel, can you get us a helicopter?
We have 2 helicopters, but only 1 pilot.
All right. We'll use them to find Manning. Eric, you go with the pilot, and I can fly the other one. Colonel, it's imperative that we find him as quickly as possible.
Mm-hmm.
We think we've found the cure, but only if we get to him in time.
Time, which is relative, which we also invented today.
These things are neat. I'd rather have a puppy, though.
Well, I can see the controls. Oh, that's... there.
See anything?
Well, there's a 50-foot guy, but he's got hair. That can't be Glenn.
I can't.
The pilot's over.
Calling helicopter Charlie Dog. Calling helicopter Charlie Dog. This is helicopter William X-Ray. Come in.
No, this is Charlie Puppy Clown. Come in.
Charlie Dog. Over.
Pirate Dog.
We're in a completely different helicopter. Over.
Over. Visibility good. No sign of it.
Hey, there's something in your ear, Bob.
I was just remarking to the others how different our helicopter is to yours. Over.
Keep in touch. Off and clear.
Good luck with that completely different chopper there, over.
Roger that. Yep, chopper's still different. Over.
Oh, damn. That's a cute one.
Calling helicopter William X-Ray.
Which is different from our helicopter.
Charlie Dog, come in.
This is William X-Ray. Go ahead.
We are over Boulder Dam.
Or at least there's some stock footage of it here.
Everything looks normal. We're heading towards Las Vegas.
We'll meet you at the Tropicana.
It's getting late, so if you don't find them within the hour, you turn back and we'll continue tomorrow.
You know, which helicopter is that?
The different one.
Hmm.
The distance between our position here and the location where you spotted the dead cattle, marked by the pin, is only about 50 miles. Now, he certainly can travel faster than that. He's been gone over 15 hours.
He's probably been moving back and forth in an aimless pattern.
Gadding about the desert in his cute little sarong.
I'll never understand why someone hasn't reported seeing him.
Huh.
How tall would you guess he's grown to by now?
50.
What's green?
55 feet.
You like Peter Allen.
Sooner or later, someone's bound to see him. Maybe take a shot at him. Colonel, maybe we're making a mistake in not informing the civil authorities.
No, I can't do that. You know the orders.
We could use help in tracking him down.
I'm not worried about finding him. As soon as it gets light, I'll show you some action.
Say!
I just hope he lasts through the night without getting into trouble.
Hey, boys. How big do you think that old colossal man's gonna get, huh?
Boy, 100 feet, 500 feet, who knows?
Sky's the limit. That's what they say in these kind of situations.
Yeah, Sherwood likes to know.
Yep. What do you think you'd say to him if you finally got to meet the amazing colossal man anyway?
Well, one thing's for sure. Wouldn't use any of those dumb old big guy cliches.
Right. Oh, you mean like, how's the weather up there?
Right, or where do you get your pants? Right?
Or any more at home like you?
Or you going out for varsity basketball this fall?
Can you see my house from here? How many times have you heard that, huh? No, not me, not me. I'm different that way. I think I'd probably ask him some real thoughtful questions, you know, like, what's your sign, or... Do you think B. Arthur's funny?
Oh, I'd ask him. How do your chromosomes work when they're the size of stepladders?
Yeah, I was going to ask him if it's true that Cher had some ribs removed.
Oh, oh,
hey,
oh,
hey, oh, holy buckets, we hit something.
Oh, Joe, you dropped your Barbie.
Forget Barbie. Give me rocket number 9, Pronto.
Ow. Damn, I hate that. Wow.
Wow.
Is that you, Glenn?
No, it's Kate Smith. Who else do you know that could take a satellite in the gut?
Jeez, sorry.
Hey, what are you standing on, big fella?
I don't know. Some planet. It's supposed to be good for you. Earth, I think. Yeah, Baltimore.
I had a whole bunch of things to ask you, but now that you're here, I'm kind of tongue-tied.
I'm not. Hey, say, is it true that Cher had some ribs removed?
Shut up, Curl. Say, what have you been doing since the movie, Glenn?
You know, bit parts, Mr. Clean, Green Giant, that kind of thing. Excuse me for a second. No, I really thought that part in Time Bandits was going to kick it loose for me. I thought that was going to make me, but no. You know I can't even get back in Vegas anymore? Vegas! Blackballed. Can't get in.
Well, you didn't exactly charm the pants off him last time you were in Las Vegas, Glenn.
You think I'm a freak, don't you?
Uh-oh.
Oh, way to go, Servo.
Oh, everybody hold on to something.
That's right, I'm a freak. I look like Peter Garrett, I dress like Sabu, for God's sake, and I eat livestock by the handfuls. I bet you just want to run home and tell all your buddies about the half-naked circus freak, don't you, Sergeant? That's right, everybody take a big, steamy gawk at the circus freak. Oh, my heart. I've got to go.
Boy, safe again. I don't get it.
All those aliens, we should be dead 10 times over.
Wow. Yeah, you know, I gotta remind myself to write down some questions next time. Yeah.
This weekend, a super special sports monster at a super special time. Super special moment.
Hey, where the hell's my Mr. Bubble?
Super special guest.
Why am I doing this?
Super special questions.
What kind of a student athlete would Jesus be?
What kind of sports show do you expect on a comedy network?
Kids, they never forget. You had $10 on you?
Don't miss the first annual Sports Monster All-Star Hall of Fame All-American Super Special.
Yeah. You owe me $20.
Noon Saturday here at Comedy Central. If you like them fresh,
you'll love them Fisher. You can see how fresh Fisher Nuts look. Smell how fresh. Taste how fresh. If you like them fresh, you'll love them Fisher. Fisher Nuts are Fisher Fresh because they're vacuum-packed in steel cans to lock its freshness. Fisher Cashews are fresh and creamy. Fisher Pecans, fresh and crunchy. Fisher Mixed Nuts.
If you like them fresh, you'll love them Fisher.
New album of the decade is burning up the airwaves. This is Guitar Rock, a giant four-record set. Original hits by the original stars on 4 LPs or 2 double-length cassettes, $19.99. 2 compact discs, $24.99. Nothing rocks harder or louder. Have your credit card ready. Here's on order.
Or to call 1-800-733-3700. Or send $19.99 for 4 records or 2 cassettes, or $24.99 for 2 compact discs. Plus $4 shipping and handling to Guitar Rock, P.O. Box 65785, Salt Lake City, Utah.
You know, we're so lucky you didn't kill us.
Boy, we never get killed by those aliens.
If anything comes in, no matter how trivial, if it's about the giant, call me. If I'm asleep, wake me.
If I'm walking on air, pinch me.
Sergeant, place a call to the Nevada State Police. Ask them to report anything unusual. Missing cattle, broken fences.
Big guys.
Anything out of the way.
What will I give them for a reason, sir?
Tell them I'm hot.
Think of something. Anything.
Yes, sir.
Love you. Bye.
Doctor...
I love you. Don't ask me why, just do.
And I'd like a straight answer. Well, yes.
Marry me.
Do you consider Manning dangerous? If we can get to him, we can help him. You haven't answered my question.
Got a point.
I truthfully don't know. Well, I want to make something clear to you, Doctor. I've ordered up two more companies of men to help with the search, and I don't intend to risk casualties.
Why, you sneaky monkey.
If, when they find him, he shows any signs of violence, we'll have to stop him. And I mean stop him cold.
Ooh. It's not a wild beast you're talking about. He's a human being.
But a potentially dangerous one, Miss Forrest. We won't hurt him unless he gives us cause.
Like Rodney
but
King.
His mind is sick. There's no telling what he'll do or where he'll go.
He's out there somewhere, and we'll find him.
Or my name is...
It's so painful being a crappy special effect.
Boy, he's really kind of flimsy and shallow there, isn't he?
Wait a minute. It's Mr. Ziffel from Green Acres. Check it out.
Oh, I bet he does something really funny, like throw a bottle away.
Not another
There's
drop.
There's the bottle.
Not another drop as long as I live. So
I
drop.
I knew it.
Woo! That was hard to predict, wasn't it?
Oh, Glenn, sarong, wedding night, leather clown suit, no, not the circus tent, no, Glenn. Either those curtains go or I do.
I think you'll last for a while.
It's such a lovely moonlit... Oh, Glenn.
Time for my only song. Glenn, my giant one.
Glenn, is that you? We've got your mail.
My loving Glenn.
He should have been confined. A fence or something. Maybe chains. We had no business letting him run loose like we did.
How were we to know?
We should have known. The symptoms were there, Eric, in black and white. He was so engrossed in finding a cure, we failed to recognize the warning.
I heard tuna fish.
Any word yet?
No, not a thing.
If only we can find him before it's too late. Why did I have to argue with him?
Now another one to take the blame. I'm going to bed before it's my turn.
We're taking off quite early in the morning. Is the needle and medication all set?
Since he left, I'll double check.
Do you want the rest of this sandwich? Good.
Carol, a few days ago, I suggested that you leave. Now I'm going to insist that you leave. It's no longer safe for you. Glenn Manning is a sick man, in mind as well as body.
Dr. Lindstrom, I'm not leaving.
I've already wired Washington for permission to lift security restrictions.
He's got it wired.
Now, the restrictions will probably be unnecessary by morning anyway. Someone's bound to see him.
You had no right to do a thing like that. Don't you have any heart?
Nope.
You're an intelligent girl, Carol. Can't you see the futility of the situation? There's nothing more that you can do to help him. Besides, if and when we do find him, it's very likely he won't even recognize you.
Then you don't believe that you can save him?
Nope.
Possibly. If we can get to him in time.
Well, I'm not leaving until I know.
Don't use the bathroom. I kind of put a hole in the ozone.
We've had two more reports of slaughtered cattle.
Was it anything else?
Guess who?
Well, they scared Mr. Ziffel and bit the head off Ebb.
Oh. And Manning is about 10 times the height and width of a normal man.
So I charge you, tailors of America, dress this man.
As Dr. Lindstrom and Dr. Kolder can estimate, Glenn Manning should weigh about 18,000 pounds.
If he's been eating right.
I don't anticipate any trouble whatsoever in finding our giant. In fact, we possibly could have found him last night.
But it was the wrong guy.
Reported seeing him. But since we don't know exactly what mental change may have taken place during Manning's continued growth, I thought it best to wait until daylight.
Can we have class outside today?
Therefore, our greatest problem is not in finding him, but what to do with him after he's found.
Put that pipe
Dr.
out,
Lindstrom,
Rockwell.
Now, naturally, we're not certain that it'll work. But the success or failure of the treatment may very well depend on how soon we're able to administer it. Under Colonel Halleck's command, you men will be in charge of the search. Now, as soon as he's found, Dr. Kolder and I will fly to him in a helicopter and take over from there. Colonel?
Boy, I really bit it up there, didn't I? Tough crowd.
As you know, this is our position here. Slaughtered cattle have been found here, 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 and here. The two motorists reported seeing him at this point here on Highway 93. And from the way he's been zigzagging back and forth, we can assume that Manning is somewhere here in the southern tip of Nevada.
Drunk.
And we're going to cover every inch of it until we find him.
So with a little guy named
Sprout.
Now,
here's the procedure of operation. Six observation planes were sent up from the Victorville Air Base and are now searching from the air. They will be in radio contact with me at all times.
Cool.
Captain Hamilton, you will divide your company into units of 25 men. And starting from our position here, you will fan them out in an arc of 180 degrees and head east. Captain Fraser, you will also divide your company into units of 25 men. Trucks will take them to the place where Highway 91 crosses the border of Nevada and Arizona.
Next to the stockings.
You will then fan them out in an arc of 180 degrees and head westward. I will accompany one of your units. Are there any questions?
Is this going to be on the final?
What do we do when we spot him?
Run!
With the radio. Now, when you see him, report to me immediately. I will relay the information to the helicopter of Dr. Lindstrom and Major Coulter, and they will rush to the spot to medically treat him. And now a word of warning.
He's
You are not to advance any closer to the giant than 50 feet. Your men will be well armed, but you are not to fire, except in the case of self-defense. Remember, stay away from him. The giant is potentially dangerous.
All right, Jack and the Beanstalk red for tomorrow, people.
You know, I think this is the oldest battalion I've ever seen.
Yeah. That's right. Lindy, headed for Paris.
Dust is deployed.
The Army's best stock footage is called to duty.
Yeah, it looks like they must be visiting Keith Richards.
Oh, I jabbed it in my foot. Oh.
Is such a large hypodermic needle necessary?
I think so. Remember, he's over 60 feet tall. Otherwise, oh, that's right. He might have to make more than one shot.
That's right, I forgot.
Hey. Ah, there he is.
And so the Chamber of Commerce has decided to increase the annual advertising budget here in Las Vegas.
He's in the principal's office.
Well, it looks like the FSOOE... That stands for
Sui?
Flying Saucer Observers of Earth.
Oh.
Have a competitor in the Seeing Strange Things department. And this time it's right here in Nevada. Now, it seems that two motorists driving south on Highway 93 barely missed a collision with, now get this,
got it.
A 60-foot giant. What have you got to top that one?
Here's Barry's van.
Hello.
Calling ground unit 3.
This is observation plane King Nancy.
Observation plane King Nancy, this is ground unit 3. Go
We're on. All coy and frilly, over.
King Nancy?
He's just outside of Las Vegas and is moving toward the resort hotel section.
And, oh my God, he's got a big bag of loose change. I think he intends to use it.
Ground unit 3, this is helicopter William X-ray. I heard the report.
Ceiling fan, okay.
We're changing our course. Should arrive in Las Vegas in about 14 minutes, off and clear.
There he is. We see him. He's camping it up.
Oh, there he is. Oh.
Stay out of my way, Hoppy. Say, how to get your pants to fit.
Hey, come on. Hey, I'm just talking to my friend over here, all right?
Nice jammies.
Cute. Tighties.
Well, think I'll go catch Siegfried and Roy. See you later, Habib.
Comedy Central could do it. The History of Comedy. On Sunday, August 18th, we'll show you the funniest people ever. We'll take you from the first film comedy, Tilly's Punctured Romance, right up to Mystery Science Theater 3000, the last word in cutting-edge laughs. Miss this, and you'll miss the best comedy of the 20th century. After all, we are Comedy Central. We know. Watch The History of Comedy, a 24-hour marathon, all day, Sunday, August 18th, only at Comedy Central.
Liquid bleach. Colored clothes.
Uh-oh.
great for every wash. Liquid Clorox 2 even gets out tough stains. Clothes look newer, longer.
Liquid Clorox 2.
Could doing things as well as the people in Pueblo have anything to do with writing to Pueblo, Colorado for a free consumer information catalog?
Nah.
Great legs.
Thank you.
How do you get them?
I used to do aerobics till I dropped, then I found Thighmaster. Every single time you squeeze Thighmaster, you strengthen and tone right where you need it. So it's easy to squeeze your way to shapely hips and thighs. I thought I'd never fit into these jeans again. Thank you, Thighmaster.
I recommend it and use it.
The secret to shapely thighs is exercising these muscles with just the right resistance. This balanced resistance coil is designed to give you results quickly and comfortably. Want to tone your upper chest and arms? Thighmaster will give you excellent results. Thighmaster, we may not have been born with great legs, but now we can look like we were.
To order your Thighmaster, call 1-800-726-6000. Have your credit card ready or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $4.50 for shipping and handling to this address. And if you're not fully satisfied, return it in 30 days for your money back. Plus, if you call right now, we'll also send you Suzanne's Slender for Life plan absolutely free. Thighmaster is not available in stores, so act right now.
This weekend, a super special sports monster at a super special time. Super special moment.
Hey, where the hell's my Mr. Bubble?
Super special guest.
Why am I doing this?
Super special questions.
What kind of a student athlete would Jesus be?
What kind of sports show do you expect on a comedy network?
Kids, they never forget. You had $10 on you?
Don't miss the first annual Sports Monster All-Star Hall of Fame All-American Super Special.
Yeah. You owe me $20.
Next at Comedy Central.
Kick her out of my tent for eating cows. Missed a spot.
Let me help you. Say, quick change.
Nope, that didn't make me happy. Still empty inside.
Oh no, he's gonna pee. Quick, over to the Tropicana.
The cows. All right, show's over, people. Nothing to see here. Move it along, folks. Let's go now. You too. Move it along, big fella.
And what seemed like a joke or a prank but a few hours ago has now become a reality. A reality in a king-size package over 60 feet tall.
Ooh,
Police Chief Benson has asked me to tell you to stay in your home. Stay in your home.
Okay.
The Army is rushing two doctors to Las Vegas by way of helicopter.
And that's plenty.
They apparently know what to do with the giant. What I'd like to know is, where did he come from?
I gotta go.
We'll be in Vegas in about 30 minutes.
Paul, there's one thing we didn't give much thought to.
What's that?
Just how much of a job it's going to be to give him this shot. Think he's going to stand there and let us do it?
Did you get that giant lollipop?
I think I saw him in a Japanese dance troupe.
The king, give me my crown. I'm going to have an imperial party.
I know this is the king and I.
Oh, it's an imperial margarine commercial.
Listen, I may be big, but I still know what's tacky.
Renounce the
truth. You know what the orders are.
The Army's not to shoot unless necessary.
You know, let that monster out of loose.
He's just browsing.
Here comes the giant!
And he's camping it up to beat the band!
You know, I've always wanted to do this. I was just too small to punch anybody who laughed. Check this out.
There was an old woman who lived in a shoe? I don't think so. Come to Papa.
Well, we've got this in tan with a strap.
Anyone see my contacts?
Are you going to stand by and let him destroy property?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I was going to wear this shoe. What was I thinking? I'm really sick. Well, there's Circus.
It's attracting quite a little following there.
It's a giant vase. Oh, no. Where's the Chamber of Commerce? I'm new in town.
Boy, this is a gaudy looking place.
Mm-hmm. Now, how do these people keep up with him? He's got a bigger stride. Ooh.
That hurts.
Have some celery. Don't forget to eat your greens.
Give you the back of my palm.
Danny Thomas! Oh, no!
He hates Danny Thomas.
EO11, my foot.
Ha! Brought the house down.
Yes.
We'll try to pick up some of the action and excitement through our window.
You stay here.
Excuse
me, could I get the time?
Don't you dare touch the cowboy!
There, come here, cop along, you crummy rotten little...
He hated the village people.
We're over Las Vegas, Colonel Halleck.
Oh, shoot, I forgot the giant cotton ball.
See him down there. He's leaving the city, heading toward Boulder Dam.
Hey, look, you'll be the biggest guy by a dam site.
Careful, that kind of talk will get your arm ripped off.
We are nearing the Arizona side of Boulder Dam. We'll cut him off when he tries to cross. Over.
He's just ahead of us, Colonel.
Over.
We'll try to stop him before he reaches the dam.
Over.
Right. Over and out.
Over.
Oh, he's so fair-skinned, he shouldn't be out in the sun so long.
We're going to get close enough to make a positive ID.
Does this bug you? Does this bug you? I'm not touching you.
Glenn? Is that you, Glenn?
It's Sinead.
Yeah, nothing compares to you. See?
Feels like I'm in there.
Get the needle ready. We're setting down here.
Glenn, I need you to drop your sarong and turn around.
It's Peter Garrett from Midnight Oil.
Oh, the power and the passion. There's toe there, Crow.
Oh. Hope they're going to give him a pedicure.
Yeah. Are you allergic to any medications?
Glenn, do you recognize us?
We know you're up there. Come out or...
We want to help you. We want to help you to get well.
Hmm?
Do you understand?
No.
I'm Dr. Lindstrom. That's Major Carter. And this is Carol, your
fiancé. Remember Carol, the one with the hangover?
The first step into recovery is recognizing you have a problem.
Drive it in hard. We have to penetrate the bone in the first injection. I doubt if we'll get a second chance.
You ready?
One.
Like a stew.
Two. Three.
Get the point, Glenn.
Why lawn darts were taken off the market, people.
When I play the king and I, it's the King Kong and I.
As far as I'm concerned, the wedding is still on.
Come along, honey. You know, I always wanted to see Hoover Dam.
He walks kind of funny.
Yeah.
Like Red Fox.
Three, four.
Let's move forward. Stand right in line.
It's 11. He's the sugar-free.
Sorry.
Honey, let's go get a souvenir and get home.
It's like if I was that immense, I'd at least have a little more fun with it. Like, why couldn't the giant have picked up a city bus and used it like a harmonica or something?
Right. Well, you know, you can grow to be 50 feet tall and still retain your sense of humor.
Right.
Others have. You know, personally, I would like to have seen him do more with the Vegas Strip. Well, I'm just blue-skying right now. But wouldn't it have been nifty if he would have just put on that big shoe from the Silver Slipper, done a little Elton John impression, maybe used the Landmark Hotel as a maraca? I don't know. Gypsy?
I would have taken my head. And made a hat.
Well,
he could have become really good friends with Claus Oldenburg or something like that.
Or he could have used the St. Louis Arch as sort of a makeshift chin-up bar.
Or used the 50-foot woman as a girlfriend.
How about using the Mitchell Corn Palace as a munchy, crunchy treat?
Or use an Alice Chalmer thrashing machine as an epaulette.
Or he could fashion the Houston Astrodome into a chapeau and stage a hat party with his being the grandest of all.
I think we're getting a little too silly.
Oh, I know. He could use the Transamerica building as a good place to fill his insurance needs.
Oh, what a little kiss-up.
Am not.
R2.
Okay, you guys, hold it. We got some letters here to read, okay? This first one's real neat.
Okay.
It says, Mystery Science Theater 3000. Let's put this up on the still store there, Canva. Okay, this says, Mystery Science Theater 3000 is the greatest show ever.
Oh, that's an excellent start.
Yep. I am a devoted fan, and I watch you every weekend. My only problem is that as each show nears its close, I feel the tears began to well in my eyes. Couldn't you maybe make the show longer? I think we could do that, guys.
Sure.
You want to try it? Okay. There. Okay.
Longer now.
Yeah.
Pretty neat. And a really cool drawing. Put that. You see that? Isn't that neat, you guys?
Hey, wow. We look like we're in a Curious George book.
Cool. Uh-huh. Oh, shall we put the address up on the screen, Joel?
Yep. Please do that.
Send
That'd be great.
Send your letters to the Mystery Science Theater 3000 Information Club, Post Office Box 5325, Hopkins, Minnesota, 55343.
Yeah. Okay. Give it a shot.
What do you think, sirs?
Look, if I want my opinion, I'll beat it out of me. Oh, push the button, Frank. I've got a tennis game later with the Chirping Hill Beast.
You know, I think if I were the Amazing Colossal Man, I'd throw a pyramid party, with mine being the...
Don't even think about it, Frank.
No!
Thank you.
During the day, mild-mannered Dane. At night, Super Hamlet.
Comedy Central.
Coming up, a special show with special hosts, special guests, and special surprises. It's now. It's wow. It's the first annual Sports Monster All-Star Hall of Fame All-American Super Special.
Welcome to the first annual Sports Monster All-Star Hall of Fame All-American Super Special. Nick Pakai here with John Heyman and Joe Bolster.
We'd like to tell you a little about ourselves, but I think we'll let Mr. Bob Costas do the honors.
Good to see an old friend, Joe Bolster, back. You know his story. Yeah. 312 lifetime home runs. Eligible for the Hall of Fame in a few years, and I have to believe he's going to get there. Some say he's on the borderline, but a lot of people with lesser lifetime statistics are already in Cooperstown. So we'll talk things over with the 1979 National League Most Valuable Player. John Heyman will be here. 22 clubs in 6 years in the big show. 22 cups of coffee, including three teams in one day on that memorable occasion when he opened with the Yankees. Dealt to the Mets. They're playing a twinighter over at Shea with the Phillies. Dealt between games of the double dip. Winds up playing with three teams in one day. All right, and of course, Nick Pakai is here. I like to think of him as the dean minor league announcers. 15 years as the voice of the LaGrange Filter Kings, and we'll talk about whatever it is. We're kindred spirits.
That's some mighty high praise. A small man who carries a big microphone, and I'm very flattered to be put in any company. Includes Mr. Bob Costas. You know, his introductions bring up an interesting point. We come from such disparate backgrounds, gentlemen, and yet our vision of Sports Monster is a common vision, and I think that really energizes the show.
No, Nick, that's not true at all.
What are you talking about? I agree with that.
Sure. What am I talking about? You think we're all the same?
Yeah, we come from a different background, but when it comes to Sports Monster, I think there's a lot of harmony.
All right, we'll take a look at this and see what you think.
Our story today concerns U.S. luge qualifications currently being held in Lake Placid, New York.
I hate that.
I'm sorry, John. What's the problem?
I hate the name. It's a stupid name. Sports Monster. Stupid name for the show. You know what I'm talking about. It's a stupid name for the show. It's not Monster Truck. It's supposed to be a sports show. It's a dumb name.
Johnny, I hardly think this is the appropriate time to bring up your problems with the name.
Oh, really?
Besides, it's a dumb issue.
When is the time?
It's going to be Sports Monster. We've decided the name. It's up here on the thing.
Yeah, people count.
All right, all right, all right.
That's retarded. Sports Monster. It's big. It's sports.
It's stupid. It's dumb.
So you think we all get
it? Well, I just meant that, you know, it's just, you know, kind of kidding. Well, you know, that's a good name, though. I mean...
Well, regardless of any confusion, I think one thing we all agree on is our devotion to bringing news to the regular Sports Monster viewer. The Sports Monster fan should be a very well-informed fan, mm-hmm. and we go the extra yard to bring news from the world of sport to your living room. Let's watch. ESPN, the total sports network, is counted with Dave Parker, AFS student. A half-hour sitcom in which the street-savvy slugger spends a surly semester abroad with a French family.
New York Yankee manager Stump Merrill was fired by George Steinbrenner today. Several hours later, Merrill's replacement was announced, none other than Merrill himself. Steinbrenner was quoted as saying, "I just felt some changes needed to be made. Stump was a good man and will be missed, but I really think Stump is the man to turn this team around."
Well, once again, violence marred the World Cup soccer championships recently held in Italy. After a game between England and Holland, fans of both teams rioted and scores were injured. The violence quickly escalated with England's parliament declaring formal hostilities against the Netherlands and launching an immediate invasion. British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher did not rule out the use of tactical nuclear weapons, saying, "I'll bloody well do what I have to do to teach those clogheads a lesson."
Controversy still rages over last week's Sports Illustrated cover featuring Oakland A's pitcher Mike Moore in all his glowing, pregnant glory.
Maradona blamed the mafia for the defeat. Maradona went on to blame the mafia for acid rain, apartheid, and male pattern baldness. The soccer star has not been seen in 3 weeks.
Team physician Dr. Robert Bolas discovered that Ryan was in fact left-handed. Dr. Bolas stated, "Nolan's got the left arm of a 19-year-old. I see no reason he shouldn't pitch for another 20 years.
After signing his deal, Canseco said, and I quote, "Hey, I deserve it. I'm the best player in the game by a long shot. As a matter of fact, I'm probably the best player ever. Come to think of it, I'm bigger than Jesus now." Obla di obla da, Jose.
George Foreman continues his long journey on the comeback trail. The latest speculation out of Foreman's camp is that the champ's next opponent will be Milos Foreman, the famed Czech film director.
Embattled Boston Herald reporter Lisa Olson was married today to Daily Planet reporter Jimmy Olson. Ms. Olson announced that she has refused to take her husband's last name and will be known as Lisa Olson Olson. Both her mom, Mrs. Olson of Folgers Coffee fame, and her dad, Lute Olson, head basketball coach at the University of Arizona, were unavailable for comment.
Turning now to the world of boxing, making a match, call the king. John?
Seeking a slam, dial the Duke. Joe?
Calling a catch, pray for Prince. Nick?
Time for two, enlist the Earl. John?
Want to win, credit the count. Joe?
Need a knock, knock up the knight.
Nick?
John?
Joe?
Nick?
Running for the roses, drive for the Duchess. John?
Streaking for sixes, bag the Baron. Joe?
Blitzing the bases, meet the Marquis. Nick?
Joe?
Nick?
Johnny?
Joe?
Nick?
Joey?
Nick?
Joe?
Nick?
Nick. Joey!
Nick.
You know, we here at Sports Monster will travel far and wide to all parts of the globe to bring you the latest in sports news. And when we come back, we'll show you some of the places that we took our Sports Monster cameras.
I'm looking forward to that, Nick.
Joey?
Nick?
John?
Nick?
Joey?
Nick?
Joey?
Nick?
Nick?
John?
Joey?
Nick?
Back to you, Joe.
Nick?
Joey?
John?
Nick?
Nick?
I came all the way from Minnesota just to see it, and I loved it.
It was the best show we've seen this year, and we go to a lot of shows.
I must say, I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was absolutely marvelous.
We've seen it four times, and we'll definitely be back.
Tie, the meanest show ever.
You know, there's only three things I like in life. Hitting a baseball, hitting a bottle, and hitting a good woman.
I just had no idea Ty Cobb could be so mean.
Today's players are overpaid sissies. Why, when I broke in the league, I got $10 a day. That was enough money back then to get some bourbon, a steak, and a pretty good hooker.
Ty Cobb is the sexiest thing on Broadway.
And I told him another thing.
Sure, Ty Cobb was mean, but you will be too if you miss this show. I give it four bases, says Frank Barnes of the Evening Post.
I'm Fat Joe!
We love Ty Cobb.
Hi, now at the Billy Martin Theater. Tickets available at the box office or by phone. So order now.
Hey, kid, know what day it is? It's the first day of school. The food's the same, but you got a new roommate.
School does not need to be this difficult.
Comedy Central wants to send George Carlin to your school for that tough first day. He'll say the things you...